strike three. Dodgers have won it all in 2020.
32 years is a long time to wait for the Dodgers to star in Hollywood. In that time, the Lakers and Kings combined for 9 championships. With that in mind, let's look at which teams are most due to break out of a prolonged title slump.
It is deep, and back goes Duggar at the wall. It's a walk-off win for the Padres.
Within that same division, the Padres have retooled in a big way as they try for their first World Series championship in their 51-year history, fortifying their rotation with a trio of trades, adding Blake Snell, Yu Darvish, and Joe Musgrove, while also locking up their future in the form of a 14-year deal to Fernando Tatis Jr. Speaking of starting rotations, the Braves' biggest addition this offseason may be the return of Mike Soroka from a torn Achilles. That, coupled with the return of Marcell Ozuna on a 4-year pact, has the Braves eyeing a 4th straight NL East title and maybe their first championship in 26 years.
Here comes Grichuk, the throw to the plate, not in time, not in time, the Blue Jays win it!
Since winning back-to-back World Series titles in 1992 and 93, the Blue Jays have only made the playoffs 3 times. Enter one of the crown jewels of free agency to try to reverse this trend. George Springer signs a 6-year deal in the offseason and has the Blue Jays firmly entrenched near the top of the AL East.
Oh my, the Yankees have come all the way back, and we've got a ball game.
And you can't talk about that division and World Series titles without bringing up the Yankees. Although it's only been 12 years since their last title, that is an eternity for the franchise with 27 championships. That drought also represents the 3rd longest gap between titles for the Bronx Bombers. In search of their 28th title, the Yankees reshaped the rotation by adding Jameson Taillon and Corey Kluber, while also hoping holdovers Aaron Judge and Giancarlo Stanton can return to healthy form.